Hello friends, today we discuss important question answer of class 10 science chapter 8, how do organisms reproduce? Hello friends, welcome to my channel NSP Learning Hub, because learning is life. Students, our first question is, what is the importance of DNA copying in reproduction? DNA contain information for inheritance of characters from parents to the next generation. As a result of DNA copying, blueprint of the body design are produced, which passes from parents to the offsprings. Thus, DNA copying maintain the body feature in different generations of our species. Sometimes DNA copying also create variations which are useful for survival of species over time. So students, our next question is, define reproduction. Reproduction is a process by which new individuals of same species are produced by existing organism or parents. Write two different difference between asexual and sexual mode of reproduction. Difference between asexual and sexual reproductions are, in sexual reproduction, two opposite sexes are involved, whereas in asexual reproduction, only one individual is involved. In sexual reproduction, male and female gametes formation take place, whereas in asexual reproduction, no gamete formation occur. Students, our next question is, list advantages of vegetative propagation. Advantages of vegetative propagation are followings. Plants rise by vegetative propagation, bear flowers and fruits earlier. Plants that do not produce seeds can be propagated by this method. All plants produced are genetically identical. Any vegetative plant part can be used. Thus, many new plants can be produced at a time. Next important question is, define pollination. Explain the different types of pollination. Name any two agents of pollination. Pollination. Transfer of pollen grains from anther of a flower to stigma is termed as pollination. Pollination is of two types. Self-pollination. When pollen grains of a plant is transferred to the stigma of a flower on same parent plant, then it is termed as self-pollination. Cross-pollination. When pollen grains of a plant is transferred to the stigma of a flower on the different plant of same species, then it is termed as cross-pollination. The agents of the pollinations are insects and wind. Next important question is, draw a neat diagram showing fertilization in a flower and label pollen tube, male germ cells and female germ cells. This is a diagram showing germination of pollen grain on stigma. When pollen grain reached on the stigma of a flower, they germinate pollen tube. A pollen grain contains two male germ cells, which reach to the female germ cells by the help of this pollen tube. Our next question is, explain the process of fertilization in a flower. What happens to the ovary and ovule after fertilization? Process of fertilization in a flower. When a pollen grain reaches to the stigma, it absorbs sugary secretion of stigma, swell up and ruptures. It divides and releases two male gametes which move down in the style to reach the ovary by pollen tube. On entering on the ovule of the ovary by micropyle, one of the male gamete fuses with female gamete to form a zygote. By the process of fertilization, the other one is fused with the two polar nuclei by the process of triple fusion. Since fertilization has occurred twice, it is said to the angiospermic plant undergo double fertilization. Post-fertilization changes of ovary develop into fruits and ovule develops into seed. Next important question is, what happens when accidentally planaria gets cut into many pieces? Each piece germinates into new planaria. Bryophyllum leaves fall on the wet soil. Buds are grown. as its notches develop into new plants. On maturation, sporangium of rhizopus burst. It releases spores which germinate into new mycelium in moist condition. Spirogyra reproduce under favorable conditions. Spirogyra reproduce under favorable condition by fragmentation. These all are the vegetative modes of reproduction in plants. Students, our next question is, what is puberty? The age at which sex hormones begin to produce and reproductive organ of both males and females become functional is called puberty stage. What are the advantages of sexual reproduction over asexual reproduction? In sexual reproduction, there is mixing of genotype of two different individuals, which results in greater variation. These variations are essential for survival of a species. Thus, sexual reproduction is more advantageous. Students, our next important question is question number 9. Describe the functions of the following parts in human male reproductive system. Testes, seminal vessels, vas deferens and urethra. Testes. Testes produces sperms and male sex hormone, which is called testosterone. Seminal vesicle. They store sperms. Seminal fluid provide nutrition for sperms. Vas deferens. They manage the transport of mature sperms to urethra. Urethra. It is a common passage for both urine and sperms. Why are testes located outside the abdominal cavity? A pair of testes is located outside the abdominal cavity in a pouch-like scrotum to provide accurate temperature for the formation of sperms. The spermatogenesis required 2 to 3 degrees centigrade less temperature than body temperature. Friends, next question is, identify the diagram given below and name the parts 1 to 5. It is a diagram of human female reproductive system. And the name of the part 1 is fallopian tube. Number 2 is ovary. Part number 3 is uterus. Part number 4 is cervix and part number 5 is vagina. Students, next question is, in which part of the female reproductive organ in humans fertilization take place and what happened to the fertilized egg? In females, fertilization take place in fallopian tubes. After fertilization, the fertilized ovum travel to uterus and get attached to the wall of the uterus for further development. This is called implantation. Our next question is, what changes are observed in the uterus if fertilization does not occur? If fertilization fails to take place, the thick and spongy lining of the uterus, which is formed to receive a fertilized ovum, breaks and comes out through the vagina as blood and mucus. This cycle takes place every month and is known as menstrual cycle. So our next important question is, how does the embryo get nourishment inside the mother's body? The embryo gets nutrition from the mother's blood with the help of the special tissue called placenta. This is the disc which is embedded in the wall of the uterus. This provides transfer for glucose and oxygen to pass from mother to the embryo and the waste product from the embryo to the mother's body. Next question is, what is contraception? Contraception includes methods or ways prevent fertilization and pregnancy in fertile female as a result of successful copulation between the male and female. List 3 advantages of to adopting contraceptive measures. Some of the major advantages of adopting various contraceptive measures includes prevention of unwanted pregnancies, help in family planning and population control. Some contraceptive devices like condoms prevent spread of sexually transmitted diseases like AIDS and hepatitis B. Our next question is, if a woman is using a copper tea, will it help in protecting her from sexually transmitted diseases? Copper tea is an intrauterine device and does not allow fertilization to take place.
since it does not provide any barrier against mixing of body fluid from two individuals. Therefore, it acts only as contraceptive, but does not provide protection against sexually transmitted diseases.